I was 11 years old when I was diagnosed with celiac.
Dietary restrictions can change an entire person's lifestyle, especially if it's a major health concern. Mackenzie Carmody has experienced this firsthand due to celiac disease, but it took a while to find out that that was the problem.
So basically, I threw up after every meal that I ate when I was starting when I was like 9 or 10. And then I went to Iowa City like for a whole year on and off, like going to school, and then afterwards I have to like drive up to Iowa City, and then they finally figured it out after about a year.
According to Cassette Scallon, a physician at Iowa State University Thielen Student Health Center, celiac disease can affect everybody differently.
Celiac disease is a condition that affects usually the small bowel, and it makes people not digest their food well, and so they'll get some cramping and bloating, sometimes abdominal pain, sometimes diarrhea. Sometimes they just are not digesting well. They just feel ill, can't keep weight on sometimes.
Mackenzie knows that if she continues to eat gluten, it could pose some serious effects on her life.
I could not be able to have children. I would die at a younger age, or I could develop other autoimmune diseases, and then it's basically just like my quality of life would continue to go downhill because I'd have more issues to deal with.
Mackenzie has adapted to this gluten-free lifestyle over the last decade, but it wasn't always easy.
I was embarrassed for like a long time because no one I knew had like a disease or allergies to where they couldn't like eat normal meals, so like I just tried to hide it and like eat things that were like just didn't happen to have gluten in it because I didn't want to ask for like separate thing. At first, like a few, like the first 2 years, I just like never wanted to go out to eat because it was like embarrassing for me, even though like the people who worked there like didn't really care, but I was just like, I feel weird asking, you know?
Even though living gluten-free affects her personally, it also affects the people she lives with.
There's several genes that are associated, or mutations on genes that are associated with celiac disease. So they think it's kind of a multi-variable thing, kind of like diabetes is. Some people might have the tendency, but then other things might occur that would make one person flare up or have problems versus another family member.
When I was diagnosed, my whole family went in and got tested, and they all came back negative. But they just wanted to make sure. My mom and my dad would just make me like a separate meal sometimes, but the majority of the time now, they just kind of make it all gluten-free because my sisters will just eat it.
While at college, Mackenzie's roommates also have to be aware of what she can and can't consume.
I've been living with her for 4 months, but I've known her for 11 years. If we have pasta night, then I'll make like a separate dish of gluten-free noodles and put the sauce in there, and like I have to cook everything separate and make sure there's no cross-contamination, and like she has her own toaster that she has to use.
I have to use my own toaster because the crumbs can get in there, and like cross-contamination is a huge thing. And then I just have like my own separate stuff, and I have to cook in like separate like pans. Like if it were to be used before me with something that had gluten in it, I'd have to wash it before I used it again.
Another aspect of living gluten-free that Mackenzie has to deal with is the financial cost of it.
When I grocery shop, it's gonna be about like 2 times as much than normal food is because it is made specially with certain ingredients and stuff.
When we go grocery shopping, her stuff is always way more expensive. Like, I'll get double the stuff she does for the same price.
Over the last decade, Mackenzie has noticed more options in food at grocery stores and at restaurants that are gluten-free.
In the beginning, I pretty much just ate fruits and vegetables and then, like, lunch meat, like, almost every day because there wasn't, like, a substitute for a lot of things. But, like, now it's, like, a lot of people choose to go on that diet, and more people know that they have celiac, so it's become available to find stuff, which is nice.
More people realize it now because they have the testing that can actually check for it, whereas it was not really discovered before then. So there probably isn't a change in the number of people, it's just that now they have the testing so they can diagnose it.
Due to living with celiac disease for over 10 years now, Mackenzie is used to her dietary restrictions.
I can't even remember what normal food tastes like, honestly. So like what I eat now tastes good to me. Like some stuff like obviously tastes like crap, but I just don't eat it. But like my noodles and stuff taste normal to me. But other people are like, oh, that's disgusting. But it, to me, it tastes fine because I'm used to it. But yeah.
Living with celiac disease and being gluten-free will always be part of who Mackenzie Carmody is.
Cheez-Its. I really miss Cheez-Its.